Kiwis have 2 days to mask up on all domestic flights and on public transport in Auckland. The government announcing the new rules this afternoon, which it signalled could be rolled out right across the country. Our political editor Jessica Mutch-McKay joins us now from Parliament. So who will this apply to, Jess?
At 11:59pm on Wednesday, it'll apply to anyone travelling on a plane throughout the country and to anyone travelling on public transport in the Auckland region. The government has asked for more advice to see whether it should apply to other cities that have managed isolation facilities or whether it should just be a blanket rule when it comes to public transport throughout New Zealand. Now, if you break the rules, you could face a fine of up to $1,000. Now, this would be enforced by police, and the Prime Minister has made it very clear that it's not up to bus drivers to enforce this. There's also an exemption for school buses. It does seem that we're given a bit of a sales pitch by the government here. If you follow the rules, if you wear masks when you're supposed to, it will make it easier for us to stay in level one over Christmas and over the summer period, and that means we get all the social and economic benefits that come with that.
Why now, Jess? Why are these changes happening right now?
Experts have been calling for this for a long time. I think there are a few reasons why this is happening now. The first one is about whether the public would have brought in before this. Having this scare does make a bit of a difference. There's also the fact that it was hoped that it would become voluntary, that we would do this naturally, but that hasn't been the case. And the minister also says that we now know more about masks than we did 6 months ago. There's also the fact that in the last 2 months, the number of people who have tested positive in managed isolation in New Zealand has gone from an average of 10 per week to an average of 20 per week, showing the surge of COVID-19 internationally. And all of this means that we're now finally getting that extra layer of protection.
Kia ora, Jess. Live from Parliament, Jessica Mutch-McKay. Well, the move to mandatory masks on public transport in Auckland was signalled by the government after last week's community case. More mask use has been a constant refrain from health experts, and now there are calls to change managed isolation too. Laura James reports.
Sewing machines in overdrive. And the end product even more crucial after today's decision.
From Thursday morning of this week, masks will now need to be worn on all public transport in Auckland and on domestic passenger flights throughout the country.
It's another line of defence, and so why wouldn't we use that?
Taxi and Uber drivers included too.
I'm as happy as an epidemiologist can get. We know it can be a lifesaver if we get an outbreak again.
I'm carrying one in my bag. When I enter in the bus, I'll put it on.
I 100% agree with it.
As soon as one case pops up, if they've been on public transport, it puts everybody else in danger. So, yeah, I think it makes sense.
And much better to stop the virus from spreading than to have to face another level two or even worse, a lockdown.
Mandating mask use on public transport for the rest of the country still to be considered. Cantabrians not opposed.
Safety first.
I think it's probably quite a good idea.
There's said to be an educational approach.
Police can enforce the new rules, but this will be the last resort.
I think the biggest incentive we can give people is we all want a summer break that has freedom attached to it.
Mask accessibility remains an issue in some communities.
Actual masks to get, they were running like $5, $6 at the chemist. So we already, a lot of us had lost jobs, and now you're asking us to choose between masks and 5 loaves of bread. We are helping ourselves.
Experts are calling for change at the border as well.
We're having a failure about every 2 weeks. We have to move from one size fits all, which is what we've got at the moment, to a risk-based system. So you put a lot more effort into people coming from high-risk countries.
Investigations continue into how the A to Z collection worker who tested positive last Thursday crossed paths with the infected Defence Force worker. And as that's worked out, the government continues to encourage anyone who's sick to get tested. This is one of two pop-up stations in the Auckland CBD set to be open again tomorrow. Over 5,000 swabs were processed yesterday, and today, more demand. Laura James, One News.